Can we just say on behalf of everyone, well done. Oh. Well done. I mean, well done to the team at Coronation Street for writing such an incredible story, but also to all of you for portraying it so well. Shayne, I'll start with you. Was it true that the producer sort of took you to one side months ago and said, just to know, this is where your character is heading, so that looking back, there can be little clues, if you like, as to the way his mind was working?
Yeah, I mean, Kate Oates, producer, she approached me before Christmas and said, you know, we've got this idea.
Yeah.
For Aidan. And yeah, instantly I was scared because I knew that this was a decision I had to make. Could I do this storyline? Could I do it with justice?
Yeah.
Or do I carry on as Aidan and do a different storyline? But I instantly knew. I think after a long discussion with my family, my partner,
yeah,
and with Kate and the Samaritans and everyone involved, like Calm, and I knew that this was bigger than me, bigger than the show, and the biggest thing we'll ever do. And the impact alone has been incredible. So, yeah, I knew that the moment I took this on, that, yeah, it's going to be quite emotional.
How did you work through it? Did you mentioned the Samaritans. Did you speak to people who had worked,
yeah,
as counsellors?
I had a great meeting with Kate, with the Samaritans, with Calm. And, again, because it's got to be handled carefully. Mm. Delicately, and most of all with respect,
yeah,
unfortunately, to all the people that have lost somebody through this. So I knew that it was a huge challenge ahead,
yeah,
for us to be able to capture that and also to be able to portray that across to the public.
Yeah.
And thankfully we did that. So, yeah.
And you say speaking to people who've experienced suicide in terms of those who are left behind. Cath, is that something that you got involved with? Did you speak to people who had suffered?
Yeah, I think by the time you get to our age, we're all affected in some way by suicide, which is horrendous. So we did speak to people who had experienced that firsthand.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry to hear about your friend, darling, as well.
Yeah,
it's huge. It affects everybody in some way, and I think the entire team, like you've just said, at Coronation Street, and our phenomenal writers, in particular, Owen Lloyd Fox and Jonathan Harvey, who wrote Mondays and Wednesdays episodes, have just done it so well. Mm. And I think Shayne has done it incredible justice as well.
Mm. Obviously, because we knew you were coming on today, and when we were speaking this morning, what was so heartbreaking was all of us sitting here, and I'm sure people at home and people in the audience here, all of us have first-hand experience of this.
Yeah, I mean, I can just see by looking at you all, you know, I'm sure we've all had that experience of it's a connection to someone, like a loved one or someone you know who may have attempted or whatever. And it's scary. I mean, the numbers alone is what shocked me the most. I knew that it was something that us men didn't talk about, because it is that taboo, it is that stigma of we're manly, we're full of pride, we've got all the answers, we've got everything figured out, and we actually haven't.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I think more than anything...
Or the shame thing, I think men just do. I know it sounds like a generalisation, but it's true, just men find it harder to say that they're struggling.
Yeah.
As women, we tend to open up to everything.
But we've both been inundated with messages from people who have actually said, I've been really close to this, thank you.
The bravery
or
that they have shown.
It's unbelievable. Yeah. I mean, what Coronation Street have done, it's actually saved lives.
Can I just say this as to Kate Oates as well? Because I know that obviously with the storylines that she's been doing has been getting a lot of attention.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is one of the best things that you have done for the show
and
the platform that she has used.
Mm-hmm.
And I think just the awareness that it's continuing to bring.
Yeah.
And I want to thank everyone on Twitter as well, because like Cath said, we have been inundated with confessions, people who now have found their voice. And I always say, you know, talk because your voice will be heard and there is help out there.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's really important, and that shows, obviously, shows.
Yeah. I mean, Shayne, you're the bloke here on the panel. I mean, and again, we can't generalise, as Nadia says, but why do you think that men now are finding it so difficult to share their troubles and would...
It's like Nadia said there, it's because we feel this kind of this inner pride, you know, that, you know, we're not manly. I don't know why we feel like that. Again, you know...
Maybe right from a young age. Come on, don't cry, you're a boy.
Yeah. Exactly.
Come on. I mean, it's got to start right from a small child that we say to our boys the same way to our girls.
Yeah, don't cry.
Yeah.
You know
what are you crying about?
Exactly.
What are you feeling?
Yeah, you're a girl, what are you crying for?
Yeah.
You know, people hear that as children, but Yeah, I think, I don't know, just the response alone now for the men that have come forward. I'm so overwhelmed, I'm sure everybody is. Mm. I'm so overwhelmed, and the amount of men that have actually tweeted me, direct messaged and everything,
yeah,
to say that not just myself, but as a collective, the conscience have been incredible.
It's a lot of pressure, though.
Yeah.
That is a lot.
It definitely is.
Because at the end of the day, you're an actor.
Yeah.
You know, and these are like big things, isn't it, when people contact you with these...
Yeah, and that's why I was saying I knew that from the moment that I said yes to do this storyline, I knew that it was bigger than me, so the pressure was instant, because, again, it had to be handled so carefully. Yeah. But we've done that, and, you know, it is now... The talking has begun, and men are coming forward, and that's the message.